It's pretty crazy to think that 3 short years ago was that 4th of July party where Nick was so nervous to talk to his dream girl, as he told me and my wife. And now we're here at your guys' wedding. It's just, it's awesome.
Nick and I have known each other for almost 3 years. We met by chance in Newport Beach, California. It was just kind of through friends of friends.
Yeah, I remember the first time I saw her. I was kind of nervous to go talk to her. I saw her from across the room at our mutual friends' houses. And I told my brother, my best man at the wedding, that I just thought she was beautiful.
Elise, my soon-to-be sister-in-law, actually came up to me that night and said, "My brother-in-law has a crush on you."
We like to say she's in love with love. So she couldn't like contain the fact that I had seen this girl and was like interested in her.
She was trying to play Cupid with us.
But she had already talked to Sarah, but actually before me. She got to her before me. And told Sarah that I had a crush on her, which was pretty funny. I hadn't heard that since like fourth grade.
I do remember the first time I saw Nick, and he was just sitting over to the side, and we were kind of making that eye contact, like looking at each other, like, oh. And then finally, eventually, he made the first move.
So I kind of used that as a way to go up to her, a little icebreaker, just said, so I'm the guy with the crush on you, I guess. So, yeah. It sounds kind of cliche, but like first time I saw her, it was just different. It was just different when I saw her, so yeah.
And he was about to leave, but stayed a little longer because we started talking.
She left before I did, and she was like, "Hey, I'm leaving now." And I kind of took that as my opportunity to get her number. I gave her my phone to put her number in because I didn't want to be the one to mess up and put in the wrong number. And she put a 1 in front of her area code, which I thought was pretty funny. It's, you know, 2000, whatever it was, 15 at the time. It was, you didn't need the 1, but she put the 1. I think to make sure I didn't get the wrong number.
Here we are, our wedding day. I can honestly say that I have never been this excited in my life. I still remember the day we met. I was so nervous to talk to you, but once I did, I was so happy. I was doing my best to keep my composure, but I just kept thinking how beautiful you were.
Dear my love bug, Nicholas, I cannot believe the day is finally here that I get to marry the love of my life. Through all the craziness of wedding planning, I always kept my eye on the prize, getting to be your wife. I've never felt safer or more at peace when I'm with you. I know that you will always protect me and our future family. There's no place in the entire world I'd rather be than in your arms. I love waking up next to you, your adorable morning face every day. I love that you make me laugh so much every single day. Although I may roll my eyes at you sometimes, but I love how silly you are and that you constantly keep me entertained.
Nick and Sarah, you stand now before your family and friends and in the presence of God to join your lives together in marriage. Nick, standing with you today is the woman of your dreams. She is God's precious gift to you. Always remember that, and you'll have a happy and successful marriage.
Sometimes I ask God what I did in my life to deserve a woman like you. You are everything I have ever wanted in a wife and so much more. The quality I love most about you is your unconditional love. You have loved me from the best times as well as the hard times. I cannot wait to raise a family with you. You are going to be the best mother to our future children.
I cannot wait to start a family with you because I know you will be an absolutely amazing father to our children. I love that you come from such an amazing close family. because that is such a rare thing to see, and I feel so incredibly blessed that I get to join into it.
I love you so much, Sarah. I cannot wait to see you walking down that aisle. That's good. Not too much.
There is no doubt in my mind that you are my soulmate, and I cannot imagine walking down the aisle to anyone else, and I cannot wait to spend forever with you. Love you forever and always. Mwah. Your soon-to-be wife. Oh, man. I didn't expect that so early, huh?
Nick and Sarah, nothing is easier than saying words and nothing harder than living them day by day. What you promise this afternoon must be renewed in warmth and appreciation moment by moment. At the end of this ceremony, legally, you'll be husband and wife, but you still must decide each day in the strength of the Lord that your marriage will succeed and be a testimony to the world of a godly home. Real love is caring as much about the welfare and happiness of the marriage partner as your own. Real love is not possessive or jealous. It is liberating. It sets you free to become your best self. Real love is not being consumed with each other. It's looking forward in the same direction together. Real love makes burdens lighter because you divide them. It makes joys more intense because you share them. It makes you stronger in ways that you dare not risk alone.
The proudest day of my life. Sarah has been the greatest gift of my life. I'm just so blessed to have had her, and I'm turning her over to Nick now, and I know he's going to take good care of my little girl.
That Nick and I could be forever, and this could be the guy, and just seeing how amazing he was with his family and just kind of seeing how much like we've really aligned, like our personalities, and I could just hang out with him all the time and never get tired of being with him, and just always looking forward to, even obviously still now, just I can't wait for the next time I get to see him.
I knew pretty early on that if everything went right on my end and her end, you know, I had a feeling that hopefully one day it would come to this, and it did, thankfully. Lucky guy.
Part of today I think I'm most looking forward to would probably be the beginning when I'm walking down the aisle, just because I know I and him will both be emotional.
The thing I'm most looking forward to today, honestly, is just seeing her. I haven't seen her dress or anything about, you know, how she's gonna look today, so I'm super excited to just see her walk down that aisle.
Let's not let this moment pass, baby. take you, Sarah, to be my wife. And I do promise before God and these witnesses
to care for you.
To care for you.
And trust you.
And trust you.
To cherish you.
To cherish you.
And respect you.
And respect you.
To listen to you.
To listen to you.
To forgive you.
To forgive you.
And to be forgiven by you.
And to be forgiven by you.
I will love you in good times and in bad.
I will love you in good times and in bad.
When we are together.
When we are together.
And when we are apart.
And when we are apart.
I promise to be ever faithful.
I promise to be ever faithful.
Today and for all of our lives.
Today and for all of our lives.
This is my promise to you.
This is my promise to you.
This is my promise to you.
Let's we dance. Let's not let this moment pass. Baby, let's we dance. Let's not let this moment pass. Baby, baby, baby.
On behalf of those present, family and friends, and in the sight of God, and by the authority vested me as a minister of the gospel and of the Commonwealth of Virginia, I pronounce you lawfully joined together as husband and wife in the sight of God and man, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Nick, you may kiss your bride. May I present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nick Panos.
I cannot be more thankful to have spent all 4 years of my college experience with you, Sarah. When Sarah decided she was going to pursue her dream of moving to California after graduation, I was so excited for her. Although moving to your dream location was great, I think the best part has been finding Nick. Nick, Sarah knows I would not just say this to anyone, but I completely trust you to take care of my girl. She is such a wonderful human, and I know you see this as well. Cheers to the newest Mr. and Mrs. Thanos in this beautiful marriage that we are celebrating.
Nick is the most caring, loyal, trustworthy, and loving guy I know. He's been the greatest big brother to me. I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for me in my life. It's truly been the best. You've been the best big brother that I could ever ask for. I couldn't be happier for you and Sarah. I know you guys are going to have a lifetime of happiness, and we wish you nothing but the best.